Hi guys, so today I'm going to be reacting to I Am Jenny documentary film. I've been getting a lot of comments that people want me to react to this, so I'm finally reacting to it. Also, I reacted to Jenny's solo MV, so if you guys want to go check that out, I posted that yesterday, so you guys should go check that out. But yeah, I did Lisa's film a couple of weeks ago, I think. It might have been like a week or two ago. And I really want to get into the rest of the girls' films. I didn't know films were a thing. Like, people make, like, full-on movies for them. But yeah, a lot of people have been commenting for me to react to I Am Jenny. So we're just gonna get into this. I'm a little spooked because the one underneath is a clip of her crying. So if I'm gonna be crying, I can't be crying right now, okay? I have things to do. I can't be doing this. But yeah, I'm excited to learn more about Jenny because Jenny's actually the first Blackpink member. I think it was Jennie and then Jisoo. I listened to Jennie solo because I saw it in a girl's YouTube video and I like fell in love with the song. So I like played her song over and over again, but I didn't really look into her. I don't know why, I'm an idiot. And then when I was on Twitter, I saw a picture of Jisoo and I was like, who is that? She is, ma'am. Like I always say, let's just get into it.
Jenny?
Is this like a showing people hating her kind of video? Oh my god, I feel like this is gonna make me really sad. Bitch, Nanan solo. Jenny was a bully. Wait.
This rumor began to spread when Jenny was featured in G-Dragon's song before her debut.
This must be like one of those, however. Malicious. Oh, it's like about like rumors and stuff about her.
On September 21st, like, 2018, someone uploaded an image on a portal website that shocked everyone.
Oh, I did not think this video was gonna be like this. I thought it was gonna be like a fun little video.
In the chat, one of the chat participants said that they did a part-time job at a luxurious Korean restaurant in Seoul, and on the first day working there, they opened the door to a private room to serve the food, and there was Jenny in Yang Hyun-suk's arms with her clothes undone.
Stop.
This time,
I did not think this video was gonna be like this. Absolutely not.
Didn't seem to put much effort in dancing.
This is ridiculous. Horrible, horrible rumors. People are just horrible. Student at Guo Prod to community. My schedule was for me to go to an orphanage in Bali and return on December the 5th. I was really excited to go to my Blackpink's fan meeting the day after I got back. However, a volcano erupted a few days before my return, so I needed to serve a few days longer and I couldn't make it. I was so sad I couldn't go, so I'm writing you today. Jeez. Imagine like not being able to do something because of a volcano, like, what is the wish you want to see come true? I want our album to be released. And y'all did that, period. It doesn't matter how many songs, I want to work hard on each song. Then create an album, jacket, picture, and everything perfectly. It makes me so sad that they just literally got an album, like, what? Why even was that a thing? Do you guys even know why they didn't get an album, like, sooner? And that made me cry too. Just made me realize how much I missed each other. I live in Daejeon. I'm a father of 10th grader. The biggest worry I have is that my son has no dreams, but now my son has a dream. Dream is not other than getting a job at YG. True. Other might think that he is pathetic, but I am happy that my son finally has a dream. Oh my god, that is precious. You should just be happy that your son has a dream, you know? Having something for you to dream about is just as great as accomplishing the dream, you know? Everybody's shook by her. Everybody's like, it is crazy because Jenny is such a pretty, like, innocent looking soul, but when you watch her perform, she's like such a bad bitch. Like, she's just like going off, you know. I mean, she's a bad bitch, like, it in general, you know, all the time. But that, she does sound like a machine. Like a machine gun, honestly. She won. Period. Wait, who was she against? I didn't see. Boy group. Okay. So pretty. Queen of spelling, queen of spelling. Let's go back to where everything started.
So to
stories about trainee days. What are there? What kind of stories do you want? Monthly pageulation. Oh my god, I can't speak. Really mean and cool hearted world. I bet. And end of each month. All YG producers also sometimes. Also sometimes artists win. I can feel the anxiety. We perform on solo stage, one group song. There was a lot to do. We needed to choose outfits, the group parts, we do everything. That's come up with the choreography, dance, practice, training. They had one each month? So in a month, they had to do all that. Literally make a comeback all in one month. I can't even talk because I'm shocked. I didn't realize that when they said monthly, it didn't calculate in my mind that it's like a month. You have a month to do all that. But then we didn't know it was difficult. It's just you had to do it. Yeah. You don't really think about it. You're just like, okay, this is my life. This is what I have to do. It's like school, like you go to school because you have to, you know. Right. Nobody likes going to school, but like you do it because it's like you have to do it, you know? Throw back to when it was still pink punk. The fans called Ginny, and I guess they're Johnny and Ginny. Huh? They gave gifts to Blackpink debuted in 2016. They had Karen for that, yeah. Jenny had fans. So she's always been like popular? Oh, so she collabed with somebody, that's how. Am I gonna get like shamed for not knowing who he is? G-Dragon, I haven't heard G-Dragon. I don't think I've ever heard a G-Dragon song. But you know what? I've heard the name G-Dragon. I'm not gonna lie. I've heard the name G-Dragon. Oh, she has like a full-on song with him. And this was before debut? Wait, what do you mean? What does he mean by going back to Korea? Does she go somewhere? Sorry.
So when I was in New Zealand, I lived by myself. Like my family was in Korea.
And you were so young.
I know, I was 10 when I lived there.
She was 10 living by herself?
So by the time I turned 14, 15, my mom wanted me to actually move move me to the States, like Florida. Yeah, she had plans.
Florida's. Let's not talk about Florida.
Yeah, we actually took a trip to Florida, saw the school, saw the place that I would live in, and it hit me like I don't want to live by myself in Florida, not knowing what I want.
Imagine
to
if
do.
She would have stayed in Florida, like what her life would have been.
Really, like I was like out of nowhere, I was like, I want to do music. I want to like learn how to dance and stuff like that. So I told my mom, instead of going to a new school, why don't I just come home and do something that I would enjoy for the rest of my life? And she was supportive.
That's nice.
Kind of the same, like, you know, we all kind of just dropped everything that we were doing, like our whole life just changed overnight. And and they put us into these groups of girls to survive, like do like a survival thing every month. And some people just go home after a month, some people go home.
You know how strong you have to be emotionally, physically, like everything to do that.
I trained with go home.
Like that really just hit me. Like I don't know why it just hit me. Like every month you have to like fight, not fight, but like you go against your friends. Like you have to like make these choreographies, songs, you have to do everything. But on top of that, you have to go against other people. And make sure you get like the highest rank and stuff.
I think it's nice that she gets to show off more of her abilities in rap.
I didn't know that she had a song before Blackpink. That's interesting. Really express yourself. So do the rest of the girls have solo songs too? I'd like to get into those. Somebody is banging outside. Can you not? I think they played this song too for Lisa's film documentary. Yeah, I'm pretty sure they put this song on there too. This song goes very well with Blackpink. Period. She does it all. That's a lot. Miss. Okay, Anna Wintour.
Art director of all Condé Nast magazines, organizer of the world famous Met Gala. Jenny Kim just does what.
Jenny. She gives me very much queen vibes, like the way she's dressed right now. They're all over the place. We didn't expect anybody. No. Because it's iconic! Like playing Coachella? Oh, yes. That must have been so, like, crazy. Like, that's not Coachella. No, that's not Coachella. So cute! Vogue? Ooh, those are cute. I got a comment saying that they're ambassadors of like different brands and stuff. We love to see it. Ooh. I think I saw a clip of this where she was performing. I think she sang the I Love You Baby song, I'm pretty sure. Song gets me going. So what you're saying is since debut she was a queen. But there was a rule that does not change in this life if you...
To bring her down. You know, Jenny will always...
I couldn't read that so fast, I'm sorry. The special feels... Oh, I did see that. That was trending on Twitter. I don't know who Kai is. Also, why is she getting so many hate comments? Why is it so horrible? Like, that she was dating somebody.
Jenny recently forgot to dance.
Forgot to dance?
The choreography at their concert. People say Blackpink's Jenny was chosen for the company by having a relationship with the producer Teddy.
So another reason people seem to dislike her, and
people are just horrendous.
More in their debut days, and this is because people claim that she was bullying Lisa. And you know, there are clips of her.
Aren't Lisa and her like the bestest of friends?
So mean to Lisa. When in reality, this, you know,
that's so stupid.
Very well, just how friends act.
Jenny faces bad reviews for being the first member to make a solo song from Blackpink.
Okay, and
out that Jenny was a bully at school. Mm-hmm. She was rude to his old school friends. Fans are upset because Jenny wears the nicest clothes. Jenny is criticized for saying she is rich.
I'm rich and I work at YG.
Fans think.
Oh
Jenny
my God! Seriously.
The most hated idol.
The double standard when it comes to idols is just fucking ridiculous. Ooh. I think that was like my first time ever cursing on this channel, but it's really ridiculous. Because you people can say whatever you want, you know, like regular people can say whatever the hell they want, they can do whatever they want, like they can say they're rich, they can say they're pretty, they can date whoever they want, but like let an idol do that. This is making me sad. Shit, I'm like, what she can
do. Out of humanity. Can human really say this?
Oof.
Like, just because they're a celebrity and just because they like them. Whenever I see these things, like, my hope for an entire human being is just getting smaller and smaller and smaller.
Suddenly, from the Korean idol group FX, was found dead in her home.
Oh, I saw this too.
The cause of death was suicide, but her motive is yet to be determined. In recent decades, South Korea has been notorious for having among the highest suicide rates per capita.
I did not think this video was going to be this.
Sunny's death comes amid a string of high-profile suicides by some of Korea's most renowned celebrities.
Their fault?
Singer Guara was found dead last night at her home in Seoul. Shocking incident comes less than 2 months since the death of her friend and fellow K-pop star, Sabi.
Did they ever, like... Did they ever confirm that they were together? Well, I guess, I mean, they were just hanging out. Like, they could have just been hanging out. But did she ever say they were together?
She was reading these insanely hateful comments, mainly specifically about me.
As I said, in the K-pop industry, you all know, like, the contracts are strict. They are working, I don't know, up to 17, 18
yeah.
hours a day. At least
it's horrendous.
It is painful to be a human.
Rejection,
judgment, exclusion, isolation.
And then people think she hates Lisa. Look at her. Like, what?
Expectations.
How do you even come to that conclusion?
Burdens, pressure. Doing a million things you don't want to do to become someone you never wanted to be. Bending over backwards to please the crowd.
I hope she's okay. Like, I hope she's okay. I believe YG would not let something.
How do you see an idol be like that and then you just continue to take pictures of them? We need to go backstage because she was really sick.
The last one where she just left the stage mid-concert. Like, an artist and singer tries to do as much as they can to let the show go on. Like, the show must go on. Everybody knows
that clip. Right, K-pop idols, they're very dedicated and they don't they don't do stuff like that. So if she does something like that, it's because it's serious. And I feel like I wish people would take that kind of stuff seriously. You don't leave a stage for no reason, you know? There's always a reason. And it has to be serious enough to do that, you know? But people are still gonna talk shit. They're still gonna say this and that about her. Like, it's... Imagine a thousand paying comments every day. Right. You don't know her. You don't know her. Deserves to go. Oh, nobody deserves all that. Nobody. She didn't like her face because she refused to take photos. But the reason different than you. Oh. No matter what, people are just gonna talk shit. Like, literally the worst. She can't take things. Seasick. She gets seasick. Thank you for giving me. Is she talking in a different language? Oh, this is Blackpink Diaries. Also, I'm reacting to Blackpink Diaries. I reacted to the first episode, so if you guys want to go watch that, it's up. So. True. Oh, I saw this in another video that I posted. Right. Also, like, why would you, like, the people harassing them for an album, like, I get you guys want an album, but you can't just, like, harass somebody into making an album, you know? It doesn't work like that. It makes me so sad that somebody, like me, I just recently became a fan of them. And I feel like I treat them better than some people that have been fans of them for years. Like, how does that make sense? I was looking at comments and somebody told me to react to Stay. I guess it's one of their songs. And I've been hearing them say Blink Stay With Us. I wonder if that song is like about like that, you know?
Better? I didn't understand that. It's in Korean accents, actually asked a petition to the government that kind of regulate this hate comment.
They should.
Bad, and I hope most netizens are good people. But those people who...
She wanted the fan to put the crown on her.
They don't actually have an actual reason
right.
They don't like Jennie. But I don't why they don't like Jennie.
It's because she's pretty and talented and you bitches could never. That's why. Period. She's saying don't cry to a blank, but she's crying too. Literally me. I'm like in tears and I'm like, please don't cry. And I'm like sobbing. Eat it, mom. Be careful on the way home. come back soon. We will do our best. Oh, what happened? What was this for? In the beginning, I was really embarrassed in front of them. I say things like, thank you. I feel for you guys. Respect the fact that you're... And then love and care for each other. A lot of healing. A lot of healing. Is this the Stay With Me song? I heard Stay. To precious Jenny. Thank you so much. I can't read this fast. I started a brand new life getting to know you. Love you. But like, why do people hate her? There's no reason. There's literally zero reason. Like, everything that I've seen so far are rumors. Like, none of it is factual, and like, the things that she has done aren't horrible. Like, her getting a boyfriend, like, really? I don't get it. Her getting a solo, like, it's bound to happen. Like, BTS, they get solos all the time. Like, I don't get it. Why is that a horrible thing? Do not get me wrong, you don't have to love anyone but the respect. Right, you don't have to love somebody, but you have to have some level of respect for people. Just like you would want to be respected. If she came up to you and called you the horrible things that she called you... No, if she, I can't speak. If she came up to you and told you horrible things that you would say to her, you'd be like, bitch, excuse me? But like, why is it okay for you guys to say to her? And if she were to be like, bitch, who are you talking to? Like, it'd be a problem, you know? I wish K-pop idols were able to, like, stick up for themselves. Like, really stick up for themselves. And I know K-pop idols have stuck up for themselves. And it makes me so happy. I get, like, this euphoria inside of me when I see that. Because it's just, like, little ass bitches, I swear. I'm sorry, but, like, alright. I'm gonna pause it. It's just like horrible people that, like, honestly, you're probably like, you can't fight, you probably don't have a mouth on you, like, you probably just like are a little ass kid in your bed, like, not, don't have a job, like, you know, like, you're just like there, but you're like sitting there talking shit about somebody who works 24/7, who could probably honestly beat your ass if they wanted to. What are you doing? And I know it's insecurity, it's 100% insecurity, you can't do what she does, and that's just what it is. So sorry about it, but like, if you're talking shit on an idol for literally no reason, if they've done something, period, like, whatever, you can speak on what you feel like is wrong and what's right, that's okay. But like, coming at somebody for literally no reason, just because whatever reasons you think are okay that are not okay, it's just really ridiculous. It's really stupid, and I hate the double standard that idols have to be like these perfect, honestly, all artists have to be perfect human beings when they're literally just people, like, they're just like us. I went on a little rant right there, but it had to be said. I just want you guys to know that this, I do not condone, I do not think it's okay to talk badly on people for no reason. It's horrible. Let's finish this. I think we only have like a minute left, so let's just... Thank you for being my greatest inspiration. One day you'll be married. You'll be married, you'll grow up. Oh, I forgot this one, man. I spent the most beautiful year. She's got so many supporters. Like, I know for a fact the support outweighs the hate. Even though the hate, it does get loud sometimes, like, I'm sure she knows that people love her. I love the song. Alright, I think we're done. Yeah, that's just... Hold on. Yeah, it's just clips of her. I did not think that video was gonna be about that. I thought it was gonna be like a cute little, like, this is her pre-debut, like, look at her being funny and cute and quirky. Like, I didn't think it was gonna be all that. But actually, I'm like happy that I watched that because I haven't watched videos like that. I feel like I haven't seen videos showing the dark side of their job. So I'm happy that I got to see that because I guess I didn't realize how badly it was. I always knew that Blackpink got like hate, but I didn't know it was to that extent that people made up such horrible rumors about them and like hated them for literally no reason. Yeah, it's sad. It's horrible. I mean, I already went on a whole rant about it, but you know, so you know how I feel about it, but it's just, yeah. I'm a little shook by that. I'm a little bit like, I don't know how to go on. If you ever left a hate comment, do better. I don't know what to tell you. It's a sad life, but yeah. I don't know how to move on. And I'm really surprised I didn't cry. I almost did. I almost did, but we're here, so it's just great. How do I even leave? How do I even like sign out of this video now? I don't know how to function anymore. But yeah, be a great person. Like and subscribe. Do all the things. I'm really like, I don't know, I'm really shocked right now. So I don't really know how to finish this video, but yeah, like and subscribe. Follow my Instagram, my Patreon, everything's linked up below. Be a good person, please. And yeah, I will see you guys in my next video. Bye. Me slapping the haters. Okay, bye.